Uncle Clifford. Uncle Clifford. Uncle Clifford. Please, don't put me in the mortuary. I'm not dead. Please, don't put me in the mortuary. Uncle Clifford, please don't bury me.
Katapume.
Please don't bury me.
Katapume.
Do not
put
a
ria. Do not put a ria. Do not put a ria.
Mr. Clifford. Huh?
Hope you're alright.
Very, very okay.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure.
Okay, if you say so. Well, I will get back to you. Let me see how the profession is going on over there, okay? Let's just go to there.
Okay.
No, this way.
Guys, guess what? Have you subscribed to Global Update Movies yet on YouTube?
No, hurry.
Just subscribe to the channel.
Global Update Movies.
Global Update Movies. Subscribe to.
Subscribe to Global Update Movies.
Keep watching Global Update Movies. My beautiful daughter.
Wake up, my darling. Happy birthday, my dear.
What are you doing here?
Come on. Have you forgotten what today is? It's your birthday, my darling. Look, I got you a beautiful and very expensive cake to start your day. After which I'll take you out to spoil you the more.
Leave my room.
Alright, I know you just woke up, okay? So I'll give you time to freshen up. Okay.
Do you know Chukumbi? Emma Egu?
I'm a Egu.
Ah, Egu Wanya Mong. Emma Ato? Ato Wanya Bakileke. I made it. It's you on your feeble. Me, I'm going to go down. What? 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 What?
What?
What? What? What? What? What? What? What? What?
What? What?
What? What? What? What? What?
What?
What? What? General Market, take it. Take it.
Igorogu.
Take it. Continue. Now let me see what you have. It was, if you have anything to play it, then let me see. Let me show you. Play!
Pass
this.
Yeah. Bianwoki. Mabo, what are you doing here? Have I not warned you not to come to my house?
Ichi Energy, first of all, greetings. You're welcome. But why are you so hostile to me? It's my father that you have land dispute with, not me.
Don't give me that logic. Now, see ever sleek and see poor.
Why do you have to give my father logic? Eh?
See ever sleek and see poor, so idiot.
Papa, yourself, you don't have sense. Yusuf, why did you have to give my father logic instead of pick two? Eh? Papa, you see this person you're talking to like this is my friend though. He's my friend. So if you want to talk to him, give me small accolade, give me some more respect. Knowing fully well that he's my friend. If his father is your enemy, it is father that is your enemy. He is not your enemy.
What a useless friend you have in him. Listen, Everybody from that family is my enemy.
Papa, this
if they don't give me that land, they are my enemies.
This boy that you're seeing now, this boy that just walked out, is my friend. As a matter of fact, this boy is not a member of that family. He's a son to that family. He's not a member. Anyway, there is a difference between a member in the family and a son in the family. That boy is not a member of the family. He's a son inside the family. And he's my friend.
Afam, listen. Every son of Aki Inamani is my enemy. I don't want to see them in this house, in this compound. So don't bring them.
Okay, Papa, I understood you. What you mean is that every son that comes from that family should not come here. Which means I should bring the female ones. Is that not so? All the female children there, I should bring them. By the time I begin to fetch in the girls here, Papa, don't complain, no. Because you're the one who said I should not bring the sons. Papa, I'm not. Look at Onyemboraba here. Somebody that I've almost won. You came and sacked him. Papa, do you know what? You're going to sit here and let me win you on his behalf. Bianorongo, come and sit here. Let me. Hold on. Last card. Check up. Abalamu.
I have what? What a useless son I have in Hafam. Hi.
anekunka aneme ozo
kai
Ojukwu, there is nothing I do that pleases her. As young as she is, she couldn't even say thank you when I presented the cake to her. The way she glowered at me. If not for the fact that I am Katavume's son, I would have run into a shell.
Well, you have already done what I advised you to do. By buying her a birthday cake and accepting to take her out. You don't expect her to swing her mood in a hurry.
I am so tired of her. I really am, seriously.
Do not be tired. Huh? At least that cake will cheer her up. Do not be tired, Chief Clifford. Go back to her and take her out like you promised her.
It's okay, I will. Let me run along.
But don't forget. Don't forget that the code is the law. And the law is the will. And the only will is Katavume.
Ought to be celebrating by now, but your cake is still untouched. Come on, let's celebrate. It's your day. This is your cake. Eat and let's marry.
So you will kill me the way you killed my parents?
Amanda, what did you just say?
Yes.
That I killed your parents? I killed my own blood brother and his wife?
Yes. Even deny it. I know you killed my parents. They come to me in my dream, crying and saying you killed them.
You yourself, eh? Wabu. Eh? Every time you be reacting somehow,
Look at the way you're frowning your face like a Christmas he-goat. Don't you know if a he-goat is passing down and look at your face, the he-goat might think you guys are partners. He will come and sit beside you. Eh? See, let me tell you, eh? You don't have to be angry. You need to be calming down, as if you don't know my father. You already know my father and how my father behaves. Sometimes, just behave like you did not hear what my father said. Ignore my father at some point. Certain things he say, don't take them to heart. You understand?
Afam. Eh? Afam, your father has insulted me enough.
Don't mind him. Eh?
Why is he insulting me like this? Why did he call me Nandesisi?
He called me a flavor. For goodness sake, if your father has a problem with my father, let him go and resolve it. He should take me out of the picture. Why is he calling me names?
I am Afam Efuna. I am not Akeji.
Why would my father go and put inside the picture? Don't my father have sense? Oyese has a picture. Did you tell him to snap your picture? He went and put inside the picture. They should remove you. He said, eh?
Why are you trying to worry yourself over my father?
Afam Efuna.
Eh?
Afam Efuna.
Eh?
It is only because he is my uncle. If not, Mpaga, Ometogo. Your father, Ometogo.
Hell! My brother, if it were during the days of John the Baptist, when they say that the kingdom of God is very violent, and violent taking it by force, I would have taken my father by force to go and make rituals. But my father cannot get anything. Do you understand? So let us leave my father out of this thing. Be coming down.
See, let me tell you. Eh? Men don't get angry like children. Stop getting angry like a child. Look at you. Eh? Be yourself. Mwabu, mwabu. Mwabu, mwabu. Mwabu, mwabu. Mwabu.
Let me tell you, listen.
See, let me tell you, I know your weak point. Eh? I know how to melt you. You know what is going to happen. Eh? Let's go to Odogu's bar and do one or two bottles. I know you will like it. Eh?
Because of Odogu's bar. Oh, okay.
I know you.
Because of Odogu's bar.
I know the button to press and the concrete will melt.
I know the button to press.
I think you're thinking too much about your late parents, and that's why it's creating, you know, these imaginary pictures in your dreams.
I know what I'm saying.
Come on. I am telling you the truth. Remember the saying, think of it and dream of it. Thoughts and dreams are equal and opposite.
Fine. If you say you're not evil, why did I see graven images, human skull, red candles, and all the scary items in your room?
You went into my secret room? How dare you? How? I'm sorry. I'm sorry I shouted at you. I really am. Look, regarding those things you saw, they were mere decorations. Okay? Now let's drop this topic, okay? And talk about your birthday. It's your day. This is your cake. I get it. You want a bigger one. I'll get you a bigger one, okay? A big one.
Thank you, my brothers, for honoring this invitation. As a matter of fact, it is an urgent call. I sent Ngene to go and call this boy, where he was drinking his life out with that flavor boy, that flavor they call Wabo, so that he will come and tell you what he did with the money our brother Clifford gave to him last month. John, this boy is getting on my nerves.
Hey, Papa, I don't want to talk, oh. I don't want to talk because now you are exaggerating, saying that I was drinking my life out. Who told you I was drinking my life out? I was drinking something in. I wasn't drinking my life out. Point of correction, though.
You see, our people say that whatever chased the elephant out of the forest must not be taken for granted.
Bam.
For Afamefuna to make Naji to send a distress call to us simply means that he is stupid and useless.
Bam!
Uncle.
Bam!
Yeah.
I don't want to. Let me not begin to bounce on what you people. What is the meaning of this one? Me stupid and you. What will you call this? Anyway, I don't want to say anything. First of all, my father here said. In fact, your father said that he sent this person to come and call me where I was drinking my life out. Who told my father that I was drinking my life out? I wasn't. And Uncle Biko, let me not begin to talk to you the way you would not like. Inania,
it's okay. Afafe, sit down.
I will not sit down, no.
It's okay, sit down.
Don't tell me to sit down. Okay, I'm angry now, no.
Sit down.
If there's anything you people want to say, say it, let me leave here.
Ede, my brother, you got it wrong.
Eh?
I got it wrong.
Yes. And he's again.
So he's right.
Naji.
So he does not. Now this boy, he's right.
Naji only made a complaint. So what we're supposed to do is to ask Afamefle what happened.
No, what has he to say? No, you're asking him, what has he to say?
Okay.
What has Afam to say?
Afam,
say what you want to say. Annie, so, look at Afam. Oya, say what you want to say.
So, he must defend himself. Afam, over to you.
Thank you. First of all, I don't know why my father and this uncle here, they said, allow him to speak his mind. Let me defend myself. He said, what do I have to say? Which one is what do I have to say? That is, I don't know what to say again.
You don't have anything to say.
I don't have
You're
anything
useless.
To say. I'm useless. Look at your useful. The color of your shirt now is falling like a falling breezy. And you tell me you're useful. That's him.
Go ahead.
And my father that here, was. Instead of my father to give me the opportunity to say, my father is saying, he should say. As if I don't know what to say.
I don't know when I became governor of our house that these people are now my spokesmen. They now speak. They speak for me. They are my mouthpiece. They now speak for me. I don't know what to say.
Anyway, Uncle Annie, thank you very much for at least I have somebody who understands me. I have to say it the way it is. You know me very well. I don't mince words and I don't sugarcoat words. I say them the way they. In fact, I hit the hammer on the nail. You see that Uncle Clifford? That Clifford, that man is an evil man. Uncle Clifford is a ritualist. He's an evil man. He shock you?
Annie.
Okay, he shock you? No, Papa, he shock you. Let me also tell you that the money he gave to me had touch of blood. That man, the money he gave me is evil money, is ritual money. And that money, when I was, the way I saw that money, my mind was telling me that ritual was performed with my father's head. That is why my father's head does not balance one place. That's how my father's head is doing like I got my lizard head. It doesn't stay one place, like network, rise and fall. And when I was spending that money, the money was talking like my father, always talking like my father. And each time I try to smell the money, it smells like my father. Anytime I go to buy something with the money will be talking like my father. The money smells like my father. So I'm sure it is my father that he used for money ritual. He came and gave me money so that I will be happy. My father's money. Can you imagine? Papa, do you see the way you're looking at me? You are looking at me like a hen that just finished making love to a mother chicken. Papa? Why are you looking like a hungry deity? Why? Okay, is that the best position now to? Okay, let me also sit like you.
I am telling you the truth. That little girl knows too much.
Chief Clifford, I think you need to act fast. If truly she went into your secret room, that means she has seen the nakedness of Katavume. And this spells doom for you. Even knows the rest of us.
No, I don't think. I don't think she saw the nakedness of Katavume. Because if she did, either she or you would be raving mad by now. Did she tell you what she saw?
She has not even responded to normal questions. Not to talk of questions about Katavume.
This is true.
I think you need to act fast. If that little girl sees Katavume's nakedness, let alone tell anyone about our secret, your damnation is inevitable.
So what do you think I should do now?
There is only one way out. Kill her. Right now.
Amanda,